Hi, this is Ricky Sun. I am a Pi consultant. Today I want to share with you how, if you are new to Pi, right? How do I learn Pi and where should I start, right? And because I was seeing some questions from my LinkedIn asking me many times, I wanted to learn Pi. Where do I start? I want to learn that so that I can increase my skill set, right? I already have SCADA, I know PLCs, and I want to learn Pi as well now, right? OSIsoft got bought by Aviva. Aviva have SCADA, right? So it's good to learn all other products, right? And Pi is one of it. So how do I go about it, right? So there are six way you can learn the Pi system, right, from scratch. And the first way is to, if your company invests in you, then you could take the public training, because it's a lot of money. Actually, I think it's almost $3,000 US. And or you like to invest in yourself, right? If you invest in yourself, that's fine too, right? Warren Buffett said, if you don't have money, you invest in yourself instead of invest on the cryptocurrency or stock, right? You don't have money, you invest in yourself. But so if your company or you yourself invest this money, then you could take the public training. And the public training will allow you to get an see an expert instructor from Aviva or OSIsoft, and they will teach you, right, the topic, like based on like is it like Pi clients or system administration or AF or analytics, right, or like highly availability, that kind of course, right? Those are public training, and you could learn that, and you can also, you know, if your company invests in you, that's the best thing, right? You can get to travel to a different city to learn Pi system, right? And a lot of my clients took those training before, and then they fly to other cities, right? To learn that is great, right? This is a great learning opportunity as well as visiting another city. Right, and you can have the expense and hotel and all that, right? So yeah, that's the first way. And the second way is to, if you cannot travel, you are the busy man, right? Yeah, mainly is because you cannot travel, and also you want to reduce the cost of learning the Pi system, then you can take the virtual training, right? Virtual training allows you to learn way more different things. Actually, I think there are way more options in virtual training than in person training, right? The one that I talked about before. And you could learn Pi Vision, you can learn AF, and it's pretty much the same, except it's a self-paced training that you can do it with your own time. You just have I think it has a month for you to finish the whole training, and then whenever you can get to it, you try to do it, and then you get certified as well. At the end of the day, you get a certificate, right? Same as the on-site training, you get a certificate as well. And I use this training for the people I hire as well, because I am also a busy man. I cannot train my own people with the time I have, right? I like to, but I just don't have the time, and I would rather spend the money to let people do the self-paced, the people I hire to do the self-paced learning, right? And then they will get the certificate as well, right? So I don't know, I can make a certificate, but I think Aviva or OSIsoft, the certificate the certificate they gave is way more authority, right? Yeah, so you don't need to travel, and that's, I think, it has a benefit of using the virtual environment at your own pace to do the exercise, right? So it's a little bit more work to put it this way, but you know, it's, I don't think it will be a too difficult thing to for you to learn it if you like to, right? The third way, right, is to ask a expert or to come to your company, right, to for them to come visit you and then using your data to give you the training that you need, right? In Aviva or OSIsoft, they call it workshop, right? I also offer that actually. I also can come to your company and give you the training you need based on your requirements, right? You learn to learn AF, building analytics, right? We could help you with that too. So Aviva, myself, or other consultant out there should be able to give you the training coming to you, right? So then you can utilize your own data to make things happen, right? Then it's more like this has a benefit as well, right? Because you're using your own data, then it's more real instead of doing the exercise from OSI software like Aviva, that they have created some exercise and you just follow along, right? It's more predictable that way. But if you go come on site training, you know, you've got to be knowing your own thing. You need to know a lot to be able to deliver, right? So that's third way to just visit you and give you the training you need, right? If you need to do PyVision dashboard or right analytics, those are a good option using your data, right? And the fourth way is to just learn it for free from the YouTube channel, right? You can go to type in OSI Soft Learning in the YouTube, and then you would be able to see like so many videos from OSI Soft that was recorded. Now it's Aviva, but you know, OSI Soft has its own channel, right? You just watch, I think it's more product based, right? Each product have a list of videos for you to learn. So, and I like myself, usually if I forget things or I want to do certain things, I look it up first. I look at how to, if I want to do something in the Pi system and I forgot how, and then I just look it up in the YouTube channel and I'll be able to do the work that I needed to do as a Pi consultant, right? So that's a really good option if you just want free stuff, right? Free for learning, free for, you know, I wouldn't recommend to just watch the video, because if you just watch the video without practice or hands-on, it's very hard for you to actually learn it. I think watching videos is not learning, it's you just maybe wasting time, right? So it's better if you can combine what you have in the company, like data, right, try to apply it in with the YouTube content, then together you'll get a better result instead of just watch videos, right? Okay, the fifth way is to learn it from the menu, with the F menu, right? Like it is the traditional way, and I would still recommend it if you want to get to mastery on becoming a really good Pi expert. Because if you read the menu, you'll know everything about the behavior of the products, right? If you just watch YouTube videos or just take the training, you're getting very basic level to just the common things that happens, right? But if you're going to get to the mastery level, which you know, you can answer other people questions, right? then I think go for the manual is a better choice, to not for the beginner, I guess it's to for the people who want to get really good at it, and then they just know a little bit more than what the typical PI administrator know, right? So this is a choice for reading the manual. And if you know everything about what the product behave from the manual, then you naturally know everything that you can react to based on the situation, right? So like based on requirement, you can say, okay, I know this configuration, instead of just knowing one style of configurations, right? So this is good to read the manual if you want to enhance further on your PI skill. The last final way that I wanted to suggest is to solve real problem, right? If you are just wanted to learn PI, if you're already hired by a company, then you know that's great. Then you have, if you have a PI server, then you could learn from solving problem, right? And I think that's the best choice to learn from solving real problem, right? If you are just now you're looking for jobs and you're looking for PI work, right? Then look for company that hire PI system guy, right? Then you will be able to learn naturally, because you're in the job, you will be able to learn it, right? And if you don't learn it, then guess what? You'll get fired because you cannot do the work, right? So that's kind of the sixth way, right? And thank you very much for watching. That's all I wanted to share, right? If you're new to PI, this is the way I would go about learning PI system. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video, next week.